Valentine's Day truck driver who normally rides a semi down the great gravel rivers of Nevada to deliver young lovers their Valentine's Day surprises. Note, Tito Valentino is not going to appear in this episode. It's just for the intro.
He's just there making his way downtown.
He's a symbolic gesture of Tito, you know, delivering this sweet episode to my Valentine, the audience, this year.
Aww.
And every year.
Fucking gross!
You love me, right? I don't have anything other than this that I want to intro.
Did Strength get nerfed again?
No, I don't... Well, I did change the combat in the sense that I have made a formula sheet for myself, so now I just need to plug in the numbers before... Instead of actually, like, doing the calculations, I just have them all pre-calculated, in an Excel sheet.
Done.
So, that'll speed up combat, but there's a chance combat will not happen in this episode whatsoever.
I can't wait to fight at the wedding! I'ma punch the groom.
What wedding?
Who's wedding? Do you know what's happening?
Some random people.
People get proposed to at the concert. Someone proposes to someone else. Gazamba just fucking croquet smashes the groom away.
Through the tradition.
I didn't plan for a wedding, but it's Valentine's Day, and this is also an improv comedy show, so anything could happen.
I mean, Bobo
are we
happens.
Not going to a
literally
wedding?
Literally, most things.
No, you're not. You're not playing a wedding. It seems like Jay needs a previously on. So let me kick that up for you.
By the way, Frogger made a picture for us.
Put it in the Discord for me.
Already there.
Previously, on The Legend of Zelda: Dungeons and Dragons, The Scattered Hero, the four champions of Princess Zelda had a reputation for being both a musical band and a band of traveling heroes who save the town from a wild Moldorm. And to celebrate your heroism, mayoral candidate Soother slimily roped you into performing a concert at the upcoming Sunbury Festival.
Why do we have to work at our own celebration?
It's not for us.
You're getting paid, though. Don't complain. And since...
Zombo need more money.
Since that got booked, the four of you traveled eastward, where you participated in a game called Hante's Platform, during which you lost the Phantom Broadsword and failed to secure the Shield of Hyrule, which once belonged to Link the Hero.
Five was not Gazembo's lucky number.
No.
I hate you, Wayu.
Hey, it's not my fault.
Where we join our champions now.
Hang on a second. Hey, did you just say it's not your fault?
It's absolutely not my fault.
Okay, I will defend Bayou here. It
one of
not
our weaker fighters, a Lionel, out of spite.
He did not know it was
okay.
A Lionel.
Yeah, because I looked behind the door number six, saw the Lionel.
Yeah,
he
well,
what, you can do that?
But you did know that it was twice as difficult as it needed to be.
No, I didn't. I knew it was more difficult than I thought he could not have to die to.
I blame Hante for all this.
You give him a crazy difficult match after he wagers his own sword.
Now listen here! And then I just turn and walk away.
After this, you guys retreated, and where we join you now, you're back at Sunbury Town, healed up for the most part. Zozin is still going to have these three puncture wounds going through his body from where the Lionel struck him. So under his clothes, Zozin's wrapped up in some bandages, which I guess he was before looking at his sprite, but now it's functional.
Yeah.
And we're now on the day of the Sunbury Festival. Not quite time yet. They're still setting up in the saloon. And action.
That's you!
God bless you.
Alright, so today is the day, huh?
Yes, today is the day where we take the glorious leap from being adventurers of the goddess herself into being stage performers.
Sort of a lateral move.
At least today will be easier.
Are you sure? Well, yeah.
I used to lie on the ground. It's pretty easy for Gozembo.
At the very least, for some than others.
At the very least, you should be able to get paid, pick up some good supplies, and head back there to get that shield.
Mm-hmm. And maybe a sword, maybe.
If maybe all goes well. Back. I mean, that's kind of the thing, though. You know, you're gonna go back there. You're gonna go for the shield again. Then you're gonna go for the sword again. But maybe you lose something else trying to get the sword. So then you need to get the sword again, but also play to get back the thing that you lost the first time.
And why didn't we just jump the woman? There's four of us.
I mean, she has command over countless dark creatures.
See the Lynel?
Oh, yeah, that was only level 6.
You missed it twice. I did.
As you guys are chatting,
strangle you.
All right, guys, everybody, calm down.
Soother, whose black eye is all but healed, approaches you and says, "There are my big stars. I was worried you up and ran off again to plant more trees around the countryside or whatever you lot of Johnny Appleseeds do."
Ah, I see you're healed. That's one of us.
Yep, I'm still not entirely sure how I got that black eye to begin with, but it's not that important anymore, it's gone. What's happened in the past is the past, and I think we should just move forward and focus on today's agenda.
Very right. Wise. About today's agenda.
Yes.
Go right ahead.
Well, we're gonna have a lot of fun tonight, and you'll all be getting paid 32 fucking hundred fucking rupees from my hard-earned political career, so let's remember what this is really about. Above all, you need to make me look good. Are we clear on that?
I think we already knew. I don't... Gazambos, why are you laughing?
No reason.
Are you gonna pants him or something? What's your plan?
Damn, don't let him know.
He makes sure everyone's good on that, and if no one seems to be giving him lip, then he's just gonna head on.
Well, wait,
he does wear
do we things. Need to dress up or something?
Oh, right. Well, I did have custom-made outfits made for all of you, and they're exciting. Rentals, so make sure they don't get damaged in any way, or else that'll come out of my pocket.
Be very careful.
They're all in this trunk here, so you guys can change into that whenever you're ready.
When did he get our sizes?
Don't question it.
A man knows.
We've been here ever since we got back from Hante's platform.
And when did he size us?
I went with him one day.
Yesterday.
What did you do?
Yeah.
Nobody took the measuring tape to me.
You missed episode 5.5, in which you went shopping with Soother and got yourself.
I missed the fashion montage.
And all decided on some outfits that would fit you appropriately, which you then change into.
Oh,
so I'll zoom in and give a good look at this. How
pretty we all are.
I asked each member what their characters would want to wear. And what we ended up with, for those who maybe aren't watching the visual version of this, Zozin is dressed up in some traditional Norwegian attire, per the request of Gamer Saps. What's this thing called?
It's called a bunad.
Because you're tight.
Thank you.
It's called what he just said. And,
yeah.
Does it usually include sunglasses?
No, but I love the touch.
Right. Last time Zozin wore sunglasses, Veyu called Blues Brothers. Which I think,
yeah,
really this shines. Really pulls together the look.
Yeah. And his blues brother requested a ninja tux.
Yeah,
he photo
otherwise known as a Nux.
Jay photoshopped, I think, an example of what he wanted me to do here. I just kind of followed his instructions, and this is what we got.
Mm-hmm. Looks great!
And then, Veyu, of course, as all Ritos are traditionally Japanese, is wearing a kimono. and then Sonora has kind of
They spent the most goddamn time that one.
It was Project Runway up in our Discord server trying to figure out the right outfit.
Didn't take my idea, but I guess
called it. There it is. First comment in the chat, weeb.
Yeah.
I didn't want to say it myself.
This outfit says it for you. Don't worry.
Volumes louder.
And after
the chat's frozen for me.
After the four of you get changed into your new looks, you head over to the saloon where they're setting up.
Gizombo itchy.
How are you itchy? You're practically wearing the same thing.
No, he's actually wearing clothes this time. But don't scratch it off. You have to pay for that.
I can't see my kneecaps.
Is that obligatory for your art?
It's just never happened before.
I don't need to see it.
Look, I bend, and it's just not there.
Can't you see your toes?
Yeah, kinda, but I mean, they're always there.
Okay, enough inspecting the anatomy of the Goron. Could we please actually do our job?
The saloon has a completely different atmosphere than when you were here last. Especially because the last time you were here, it was in a dream, and two cultists took you for hostage.
Yeah.
But now it's been decorated with flowers and streamers and balloons.
Four streamers, to be precise.
Five.
Five chickens.
The DM is a thing.
And then there's... Okay, if you want to get technical, one streamer. One streamer and then four guests. The saloon has a long stretch of table in which there are snacks and a punch bowl. And then in the middle of the room, there's an ice sculpture made in the likeness of Zozan holding a stick triumphantly in the air.
Help us.
I'm at a loss for words.
Finally... There's a stage that's been installed in the back, and the ladder pressed against the wall behind it.
That's how they got Zozan's measurements.
It's one of those Bell's Library ladders from Beauty and the Beast.
Gotcha.
What? Right.
So a stepladder.
No, it's not a stepladder.
Not everyone on the tracks. Not everyone has played Ace Attorney. Yeah. This is a Zelda stream. and actually, on this ladder, stepping down from it, you see Bobo crawling down.
And,
Like good, like you know, he's there, or
he's there.
Yeah,
so he's crawling down the ladder like head first. Like somehow he's like climbing down upside down.
No, he's just stepping down it like a normal human does.
Yeah,
and
what's a human?
Like a normal Hylian does. Thank you. And he sees you, he's a little surprised, but then he just kind of plays it off casually, like, hi.
Hi.
Hello,
Bobo.
Good day, senor. Good day, Bobo.
I'll be at the concert tonight.
Glad to hear that.
Yeah.
It's a pleasure to see a fellow musician will be in attendance.
Yeah. speaking of musicians and things, there was one thing I've noticed about my new outfit.
Uh-huh.
Yeah?
How are you going to play me? My tummy is covered.
Tear away.
Maybe Gizombo not think this one through.
You could play. We can see how it goes through the stomach or through
okay.
the clothes.
This isn't an undershirt; it's just a dicky. So if you just loosen this button up, you're gonna have some great exposure.
Oh, perfect. Glad that's covered or not
it's
covered.
It's a load-bearing button. As soon as you unsnap that one button, the whole outfit just like falls off.
In somewhat of a hurry, Bobo scurries off.
I don't like that.
Actually, probably
bye, Bobo.
Better. Bye, bye, Bobo.
I would like to keep an eye on him.
Oh, does somebody have some sort of romantic intent?
I have more concerns about the crickets.
Normally when you see Bobo, he's got a cloud of crickets around him, but he seemed cricket-free today.
Oh, no.
Look, we don't have time to worry about the child and his antics. We have a show to perform. Why did I have to say that?
Can I just question, are we sure that statue is made of ice?
Would it be made of otherwise?
I can smash it.
Don't smash.
Zombo knows.
Okay.
But crickets exists.
You think it's a statue made out of crickets?
Blue crickets!
Susan, are you...
Wait, no! Because I'm gonna get it! Crickets are frozen inside the statue. Waiting for their chance.
Zozan, if you needed something to take the edge off before the big show, you should have just let me know.
Do you want me near alcohol again?
Don't let him drink.
I want to say that the ice sculpture is fully transparent. You can see through and there are no crickets. And it's cold to the touch, which would imply that it's ice and not crickets. There's no real
I haven't touched many crickets, honestly. Man, I don't know how cold they are.
Cold, transparent crickets.
those ice crickets that they have.
I'm still not sure. I'm not convinced.
So while Zozan investigates...
Otherwise, in any normal circumstance, I would have struck you. But I'm actually starting to feel a little guilty about the whole Lionel thing, so I'll give this one to you.
Thank you.
And eventually, all the setup is complete, and the saloon has been completely transformed. They've set up some good acoustics for you on the stage. And Soother shouts, "Places, everyone! The door opens in 5 minutes!"
Wait, what? Oh.
Did we rehearse anything?
God, remember when we made up our set list?
Yeah, remember yesterday when we went over our whole set list?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, boy. I love it.
For one that was drinking yesterday, remind me what happened.
Look, all you have to do, Zozan, is dance. I assume, given your prodigious display when we first arrived in town, that won't be too difficult for you.
Highly indigenous.
Sonora, I already have all of my faith in regarding musical talent, he says, looking at not a character sheet. And Gizombo
the drum.
Yeah, just be yourself.
Okay.
Change nothing.
Can I just try and slap the stomach and see if it sounds good through the clothes?
Raw.
Gizombo, sticks out his stomach.
I rolled a hit.
Wait, what do you roll?
11.
11. Okay.
What are you doing?
Why?
Are you trying to play Gizombo?
Oh, he's just striking Gizombo to see if he makes any unique noises.
Why though? Why not?
If you took a bongo and then put a curtain over it and slapped it, huh, it would still produce a noise, maybe a little bit muffled. Yeah. And that's about what you hear.
Wait, like this?
Did you put a curtain over it first?
Well, fine. Here, you want some more like this? Well, let me know.
What the fuck are you doing?
What about? What about you do this one?
There we go. Zombo is tuning his stomach.
Maybe more like. Like that?
Sure.
Yeah, that's there it. That's go. The one we
that's
found.
That's the
it.
Exact sound.
Yay!
I hate everything. Actually, hold on. You guys keep practicing. Hold on.
Are you getting a lute?
Well, where you just took off.
Yeah, the doors are opening. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Students creeping ever closer to that door.
Oh, no. I like the chest surprise. I had a bongo, even though I had a bongo in every stream up to since the second one. I kept saying, hey, Ryu, can I drum my belly? He's like, no. I'm like, with these sticks in my hands.
Oh, what this is going to be terrible.
Ooh.
Yeah, that's horribly out of tune.
Oh.
You actually
are you
have
sure
a string?
You guys are ready?
Sure, listen!
Yeah, I haven't played this thing in like 6 months. So I wouldn't actually be able to play anything because I don't have time to tune it, but.
Also, you guys are desynced in a Discord call with no songs rehearsed. So, if you guys.
Hold on, and I bought these for $5 on eBay.
And Gamer Saps is going to webcam his feet.
Yes. Or I can go to my neighbor's house and get a cornet.
What?
A cornet.
Like a trumpet.
Like a, yeah.
We don't have time for you to get on your sled dogs and head over to your neighbor, who I assume is several miles away.
Fair enough.
Several miles by dog sled.
I'm gonna start rolling my dice in the bongos.
That's seriousness.
Yeah, the story has to progress. So,
anyway, yeah, that's the there's the sound of getting ready for a
tuning.
Concert.
Yeah.
Within seconds of the door opening, the saloon is flooded with people who begin to drink and eat. And now it's up to you to provide a little atmosphere.
But I want to join
shall
the
we,
drinking.
Shall we play?
Is there a plate of rocks? Because Zombo's got a rumbly in the temple.
Everybody, are we on the... sorry, out of character. Are we on the stage?
Yeah. Okay. Everybody, are we on the stage?
Sonora,
where are we?
Gazombo, are you guys ready?
Yes.
Okay, then follow my lead.
All right.
Attention, citizens of Sunbury Town. Several days since we've last stepped foot in your beautiful town, but you may recognize us as the Scattered Heroes.
Woo!
The people who've come to dance and play at your festival this evening, but also the dashing adventurers who have defended your city from the ravaging Moldorm who wanted to eat your flesh and children.
Woo!
As you sit and feast upon the food on your table, allow us to fill your ears with the sounds of music!
Woo!
Yeah!
Oh dear God!
We love music!
We really should have rehearsed this one. Just play! All right! Do I start with the left stick or the right stick?
Okay,
so... Start with the bay of fist.
Do we have to roll?
Yeah, now I want you all to roll for your respective music job.
18.
Oh, fucking nice.
18, bitches.
Okay, whoa, 18.
The curse is broken.
Plus a six. You do find the crowd loves Sonora. They can't get enough of that time. There are some people who like faint in the audience.
Okay. Oh, is that? Yeah. It's her.
I'm saving her for later. But
I
can assume that she's yeah.
A 19.
Yeah, a 19 plus 4 would be 23.
Okie dokie, you're almost up there with Sonora. So that's Also going to police the crowd, and that's also going to... People would be fainting, except I think fans of Vayu are a little bit more reserved and a little bit more put together.
Combo will faint for you.
In the corner and like looking at each other like, yes. Mm.
But that's high praise for them. That's basically fainting.
I rolled a 6.
Okay. As you take center stage, people start chanting, "Fast-footed Zozen! Fast-footed Zozen!" the 6, it keeps the crowd warm.
The feet aren't quite as fast as before.
Fast-footed Zozen.
I'm sorry, I've been shot.
And realizing that the injuries that you sustained possibly while fighting some sort of terrible monster attacking Sunbury Town, who knows, they start to respect your honor more than your actual footwork, and you get a proud applause.
The show must go on. Yeah.
Can't disappoint my audience.
All right, Gazabo.
I mean, it's a 15?
15 total? Well, you're meeting stuff.
Yeah, 0. So yeah, it is a 15, which is better than I thought you would do.
Is he playing himself? It doesn't matter.
Yeah, he's banging his stomach with a clarinet.
Because 1, 2, 3, 4!
And that, you're like the Ringo in this case. You're playing the drums, and it's passable. No one's going to argue that you're the best in the world, but, you know, you're going to kind of get the splash praise of your 3 on the stage with you.
That is Gazumbo all I ever needed. It's fine.
It's okay. Like Ringo, you're the pretty one.
Yeah.
Yay.
So the atmosphere that you set up here is one of sick parties. Everyone is just really jiving on this. And after playing for enough time, Suther comes up to you and says, "We've got some dusty old records in the back, and we can just put on a few of those for a couple minutes if you want to step off stage and grab some food. It's a party after all."
I think, Gazumbo could use a refueling. Those bongos don't run off of nothing.
And when you guys step off stage, he blows some dust off the vinyl record and puts into the player. And the mood that you guys had just set up that was rocking this party comes to a screeching halt, because this is a less than stellar song. Everyone who's over 60 in the saloon is like, "Hell yeah, that's my jam!" And they start square dancing.
Oh my god!
The rest of the party has just kind of awkwardly shuffled to their tables.
Well,
Hang on. Out of character real quick, is this the pumpkin bar from Skyward Sword?
Yeah, it is. Okay. The Lumpy Pumpkin is the name of the song.
Lumpy Pumpkin.
Dude.
Gazumbo, don't enjoy this.
Gazumbo can enjoy what he wants.
I will join you if I take a couple drinks.
We probably still have to go back on stage after we eat.
At what point do we want to cut Zozen off?
Run!
Now.
Zozen has 2 drinks.
At the same time.
How did he do that?
No, actually,
speed scores.
Yeah, Zozen, roll.
Oh, roll?
No. Ryu, no.
Oh, I rolled a 2.
Okay. Alright, yeah, no. 2 drinks is appropriate. That's about how many you get before they catch on to what's happening.
No, bad smash.
At the end of the table...
Why did you glass me?
At the end of the table, there's a platter that Grayley's mom lifts up and reveals some rocks that were laid out for Gazumbo.
Oh, you are too kind.
I don't have a noble pursuit, if you have any.
You're hooked up with exactly what you need.
Nice.
You catch Soother dumping a flask into the punch bowl.
Soother?
Are there children here?
Yeah. Don't worry, this was already alcoholic punch before. It just... It looks suspicious to be carrying around a flask in your jacket, so I thought I'd...
And this doesn't look any more suspicious.
All right, point taken, and he tosses you the flask.
But I don't even...
Hey, come look right here.
No, that's worse! I'm gonna hold on to this because I don't trust anybody.
You don't trust Gazumbo? That's rather rude.
I'm very trustable.
Why do I feel a strange case of deja vu? You know what?
You see, sitting at the bar, a Rito woman. And you're certain that you've never seen her around town before. You also notice that she's carrying a bow and arrow, and they're tipped with heart-shaped arrowheads.
I'm Gazumbo.
Yes, Ozen.
I don't like the look of that arrow.
I think it's adorable.
She catches you looking at her arrows, and she's amused by that a little bit. And so she takes one out of the what do you call the thing that you keep arrows in?
Quiver.
She takes some out of the quiver and lines it up with her bow and just kind of poses with it, doesn't fire it, and puts it away.
I whimper. No more bows.
You must forgive him. He was shot just yesterday.
Dare I approach her?
Don't. Well, you seem don't to be do the it, Zenora.
One who has the most luck, yes, with the fairer sex in our group. So,
just get the bow away from me.
All right, I'll go for and ask her what she's up to. I stroll over to the street alone. There's some fancy-looking arrows you have there.
She looks over to you and says, "Well, we can talk, but are you going to buy me a drink first?"
Whoa. Cutting right to the chase, aren't you?
Damn. I overheard and took the bottle away from Vayu and threw it to you.
And she catches a flask out of the air and says, "That works." This is straight vodka.
No, we're wondering what was in there.
Well, that solves one problem, I guess.
I can try to help. I'm not always drinking by myself.
No, just with strangers.
Fair enough.
She coughs down on the vodka that she's been given. And says, "My name's Amarisa."
Amarisa. And where does this Amarisa come from?
There's a place down south where us Ritos hang. It's called Dragon Roost Island. I just happened
Sounds
to
exciting.
Be on my way down there. I was up in the north in the Tolingo Plains doing some arrow work, but now I'm heading back home, and I couldn't resist a party like this.
I, very pointedly do not ask what arrow work means.
Why not?
You were asking about my arrows, and she hands one to you and says, "These here are my special custom-made arrows. There's a secret ingredient stored in the head."
Secret ingredient.
Yeah. But petrachotoxin. But, you know, I call it love. It's,
love arrows.
It'll make sure that if your first arrow doesn't do the trick, you don't need to fire a second one. You just need to give enough time and they'll collapse on their own.
Collapse?
Collapse?
You're saying this arrow knocks people out?
Oh, yeah. Well, if you don't put the antidote in them, it'll kill them with enough time.
I curled together behind Kasambo.
Just kind of spread up my arms a bit.
Is he okay?
No.
He's fine.
He got shot yesterday.
Three.
He's a little alive.
He's a thing with arrows. But if these arrows are as dangerous as you say it, then you're just waving them around like it's nothing.
Oh, well, I've got a ton of these. It wouldn't do me any harm if one of them were to go missing, but... I keep an eye on my own belongings.
Alright. If you're as experienced with these as you suggest you are, then I suppose you can be trusted with them. For now, has an idea. I say under my breath.
Yes. Oh no!
I want to see how stealthy I am.
So tell me, why are you so interested in these arrows?
Well, they're very unusual looking arrows, you must admit.
Well, I do have my own flair that I like to put on things that belong to me.
Oh, of course. I know how that is. I had to splurge just to get a... replace my old sword with a scimitar. I felt it matched the look.
And I'm going to use DM magic and say that Sonora could have had the scimitar with her for this conversation. Oh. Just for the sake of,
For the sake of... I did not realize... I forgot that was... would be a strange thing to have with me. In the
yeah.
Take a look at this.
I don't know.
I have my hammer.
It's kind of part of your band's shtick that you're both brave fighters as well as musicians. So,
hey, we know how to accessorize. That's all we're saying. Gomez in the chat. Every sentence these two utter, I'm asking, is that an innuendo?
The answer is yes. It's Valentine's Day, almost.
Just two gals in fancy dresses comparing lethal weapons.
Reason for the season. Sonora, if you're on the stage, can you do me a favor?
What's that?
She hands you a vinyl record. How about putting on some real music? It'll liven things up around here.
Real music, huh?
What's on that thing?
I think I can arrange that. I take the record and look at it. Is there a label?
No, there's no label. There's a duct tape label that says good music.
Well, thank God!
Oh, good. Duct tape exists in this universe.
It's since she's a Rito woman, it's duck tape.
Fuck!
How about that?
That's you.
A pun. Who would have thought?
Good news. Right.
Dude, so should we give it to Kasama, let him sneak there and change to the vinyls?
There's really no reason to sneak.
The people at this party would be... oh, so gracious if you were to.
Well, nothing to it but to do it. I take the record over to the... what's it called? What kind of
record
phone?
Record player?
Phonograph.
Phonograph. Yes.
And you put the needle on this baby.
What's the old-timiest name?
Um,
The party like livens this. Up at the sound of this new music. The square dancers are a little disappointed, but no, even they're into it. Everyone has gotten up and is starting to form kind of a dance puddle in the middle of the room.
I have to admit, I like this song. Still scared of the arrow.
Look at Kazambo go!
Yeah!
Is he spinning?
Oh, I forgot about that.
Watch me do the sandworm!
I have good taste in music.
Yeah, well, this ain't my first party I've crashed. You come prepared for when things need a little more action.
I hear you there.
Okay, that was definitely an innuendo.
Someone else try to say him.
While Sonora continues to have a conversation with Amarisa.
Amarisa.
Someone else, maybe Vayu, maybe Zozin, maybe Gizambo, somebody else is going to notice Bobo has now entered the room.
Yes. With his burlap tux.
With his burlap tux, and he's done his hair for the first time.
Oh, I like it.
I'll notice Bobo, like, walk into the room changed, and, like, as Sonora is busy, I'll sort of, like, elbow Zozin and Kazambo. Be like, guys.
I'm still learning. Oh, no.
What?
Again, no crickets.
But what about the one in his hand?
That is a dramatic representation of the scene.
Okay, imagination is no longer there. Okay.
An origami cricket.
The ring!
Maybe he's finally cleaned up his act.
This soon?
He's still wearing the mascara.
Okay, but he's not surrounded by crickets. Baby steps.
Alright.
Have anyone looked outside?
You can peer out the window of the saloon. And there is not a swarm of crickets or anything quite that obvious.
I look up.
Okay.
Do we hear any crickets chirping?
Now that you mention it, yeah, there are crickets chirping. Not really sure from where.
How many?
It's hard to say. It's not like you're an overwhelming number of crickets. It's just that you can hear it no matter where you're standing in the room.
Oh, boy.
Oh, no.
You guys are too worried.
Does Gazambo have hammer?
Gazambo? Even though I'm still scared, no.
I can at least get one at a time.
That would somehow be worse.
And my face at the same time.
Just be careful of backswing. I told you every time.
I still remember... when I was
Straightened your nose. It was fine.
It was never the same.
Did you still smell?
No.
He sure does.
Oh.
Sorry.
Cut that.
So, should we be concerned?
I think we should approach, at least.
Bobo is kind of... He hasn't assimilated into the dance pile or anything, but he has worked his way over to the food tray.
Is he eating crickets?
Hungry, though.
No, he's not. God. He's eating deviled eggs. Oh, he's eating all the deviled eggs. He's that guy.
He pops one in his mouth. He, like, waits a few seconds, looks around, picks up another one.
The Rodney Dangerfield hors d'oeuvre sandwich.
You know what? I'm actually going to approach him and see what's going on.
Wait, does the devil exist in this? How can it be deviled eggs?
Ganon.
Ganon eggs.
Ganon eggs!
Ganon eggs! He's eating all the Ganon eggs! Which makes it sheds a disgusting light on it, I think.
It's just an egg, like, hard-boiled. You take the yolk out, you scramble it with some mayonnaise, and then you put pork grease on top of it.
Do you think that actually,
yeah,
from
I
an egg?
Be opposed.
Yeah, I'd try that.
Zozan approaches Bobo.
Hey, Bobo. Bobo.
Nice dress you got there.
Dress?
It's, same thing I was wearing the night you took me to the inn, and
yeah,
the night
good fond memories.
Grayly threw me out of the inn.
Still sorry about that.
It was right at that Seriously. Table, right at that table when we sat down with her. You promised
you know
me
what?
Everything would be okay.
Yeah, I'm still sorry about that, but it's still the possibility of being okay later.
You know, Bobo.
It can always be
Gorons
okay.
Live for a long time, and eventually
when
it will
here?
Be okay.
He has no more time for that, and he just continues to munch down on his eggs.
Wait, no, I thought I saved the eggs.
Oh, okay, sure. He,
you just snatched the plate from
him? He pours a bowl of punch, and a glass of punch, and says, I'll trade you for the eggs.
You're welcome.
No!
And Zozan gets drink number three.
No!
Well, Bobo gets the tray.
We're not performing again this evening, got it?
No, his dance will get better. It's pretty weird, actually.
It'll eventually flip back to zero. If you
this allegedly double-spiked punch.
Wait, guys, how old is Bobo?
Okay, actually, oh no. We kind of worked this out in the Discord channel. In episode 2, Grayly says, she expressly says that she's 20 years old. And then a few minutes later, Grayly's mom says Zozan looks around dating age for my daughter. So one can assume that Grayly and Bobo are both 20, and Zozan is in his early 20s at least.
I mean, now, just look at that beard.
18.
I don't know how that happened, but I guess I'm always 18.
We said during the Muldorm battle that Zozan used to bottle feed Gazombo, which means Gazombo has to be younger than Zozan by like 4 or 5 years.
What?
Lava?
Crushed rocks.
Rock juice.
Or that.
Just hot spring water, we'll say.
So Gazombo is like 17, 18. Zozan's like 21, 22, 23. And the rest are indetermined. I don't. We came up with some number, but I don't remember.
Yeah, did we ever determine if whether Vayu or I was older?
Yeah, I think my age range was somewhere between 20 to 25 or something like that, or 21 to 26, and I forget what.
Yeah, you were a soldier.
Yeah.
All right.
Because Vayu lives alone and has a military job, so he's at least in his like 20s.
Okay, and I think I said like mid-ish 20s. So if I'm the oldest, it wouldn't be by much.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, but I don't know what the drinking age is in Sunbury Town, and whether or not Bobo can drink the punch.
But he didn't. He traded
but he
it.
Didn't. He traded it. He just wants those sweet, sweet eggs.
Oh my God! The chat is right. Sorry, I got distracted. Zozan looks like ZZ Top.
That's true. Oh, that's very true.
Moving on from Bobo,
yeah.
I guess while that's happening, Sonora notices Grayly is in the crowd, and she's trying to have a good time.
Oh no.
She's not paying any mind to Sonora or anything, she's just trying to dance along with the music.
How did she get that so quick?
She just has so much sensibilities.
Sorry, I'm just freaking out over this music.
Wait, it's Zelda. I think this one's from Skyward Sword. I wouldn't pay too much attention to the music. We've got a show to do.
Alright. Let's go all the way tonight!
So...
Wait, I just heard the music. What's happening?
Just look at the screen, Jay. Just look at the screen.
Sonora...
Is this Kids Pop?
No.
Let's move on!
Okay, Anne Marisa actually notices Sonora kind of looking off into the crowd, and she asks, is there something out there? What's going on?
I just feel like somebody wore the same dress as me.
Sonora, or Grayley rather, then notices Sonora at the bar. And works her way over and says, "Hey, Sonora! Who's your friend?"
Hey,
Marisa, she says, and shakes.
I say.
You say, and then she says, you say at the same time.
Okay. I totally didn't forgive it because I've only heard it twice.
So is she going to be, like, in town for a long time, or... No, I'm just blown by. Whew! Okay. Hey, Sonora, want to dance?
Do it!
I haven't danced in a long time. Sure.
Fix that!
So you guys go to the middle of the floor and start cranking it.
You don't mind, do you?
No, go ahead. And while you two are dancing, Bobo, with a mouthful of eggs, kind of sees this and goes...
Damn with it. A mouthful of eggs.
Hey, Timo.
Yeah?
Timo?
Look at her. Having fun, acting like nothing's wrong. Isn't it?
Which one of them?
God damn it, the gorgeous one!
Which one of them?
The bird?
God damn it, you idiots.
Clunk, clunk, clunk.
Yeah. What about it, Bobo?
I can't believe that she can just be so happy. It's not
aren't
fair.
Aren't you happy for her?
But I'm sad.
But we can be sad together. I'm also alone today.
Whoa.
Not like that.
Vayu hears this, immediately just spins on his heels and is like, I'm gonna go check out that buffet. This show just got way too weird for my
Bobo puts the tray down and looks at Zozin with a serious, surprised, perplexed face, but he's filled with confidence and says, yes. We should plot something together.
Like what?
Oh, can Gazambo help?
Oh, Gazambo, get in here.
Yeah.
Marco and I were just talking about what plan we should do.
Oh, to who?
To everybody. This whole damn town.
Oh.
I've already got some things set up. How about, when the night starts calming down, you let me get up on stage? How about it?
Note that neither I nor Vayu are within earshot of this conversation. He does have no way of stopping it.
I mean,
Gizamo, can't see anything wrong with that. Can you use those in?
Maybe, but I also want to pay back for Weyu.
So, we have a deal?
Don't know if I like the sound of that, but alright.
This seems like a bad idea, but okay.
Sure!
If you promise me that you don't ruin the party.
I...
got real quiet.
I promise I won't ruin the party.
Handshake.
What a believable gentleman.
And,
look me in the eyes, shake my hand, and agree.
Bobo shakes her hand, looks you in the eye, no aversion whatsoever. He says with confidence that he will not ruin the party.
Oh boy.
Good.
Meanwhile, Soother kind of walks around to all of you and says, all right, people, it's time to get back on stage and play another set. Let's go, go, go. And you can all tell right, by his walk, he's a little bit tipsy.
I finish eating, having been using it primarily as a distraction from whatever insanity Zozan was getting himself into, seeing that Soother's apparently trying to rally us again, and swallowing the, I don't know, vegetable fish. Of choice. Yeah, the fish, sure.
There's like kippered herrings over here, it's great.
make my way back towards the stage.
Bobo says, not this time, next time, next set.
Gotcha.
So I see.
By the way, what are you gonna do?
Clandestine arrangement between Samson and Bobo. And I kind of like look at him cross.
I don't notice immediately.
What are you. Why does he seem. What are you planning with this gentleman?
We're having a fun time.
It's time for you guys to to roll for another musical set.
Alright.
Oh my god!
I am ready for this.
1, 2, 3, 4!
Well, apparently I was destined to be a musician in this campaign, so...
Same, right?
Well, alright, what'd you get?
I got a nat 20.
Okay.
Oh, shisa.
24, and Sonora?
I got another 18.
Okay.
Nice!
That's...
I got a 9.
That's also 24, isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah.
So... Yes. Sonora,
two wait. Times multiplier bonus!
No. Sonora and Veyu both equally tear it out. I think it's kind of a duet between them at that point. With,
Gasambo, join me for this dance.
Wah! Gizamo will try.
Work out
how does a 7
routine
do?
Where, like, Zozan has to dance on Gizambo, or, like, on his yeah. stomach.
Oh, God, that's a good idea.
Oh, I'm gonna see those rocks again.
Okay, alright, no. Only, alright. Only Zozan roll, but roll with advantage, because you're kind of eating Gizambo's roll.
Alright. I roll a 6, and I roll,
yes,
an 18.
An 18, oh, there it is. Right. Woo, I thought you weren't going right. to get it, even after I gave you that. Saving good.
Thank you.
So, you're dancing to the beat this time on Gizamo, and you're kind of, it's both pleasing the Zozan fans, but also winning over some of the Gizamo fans. And I'd say it all around. What?
Oh.
Did I say something wrong? What? Oh, okay. Never mind. I thought I heard something. All in all, this was your most successful
you?
Musical.
Oh, you were roboting it up for us.
Roboting. Oh, that's what's happening.
Yeah. You sound good now.
Okay, then. I'm just going to try to get through the sentence.
Line from the top.
All in all, this was the best musical performance that you guys have done as a group so far. And I'd say that the crowd is in much, much, much better spirits than they were probably since this campaign started. Everyone is just having a great time, and the music continues from the records as you guys step off stage.
Yay!
I'm starting to feel better now. And now I question your music again.
Hey, Zelda, don't worry. I think this is Twilight Princess.
I want to hear this out.
There's nothing to hear. It's just some music. It's just some Zelda music that I pulled for this episode.
Okay.
This is the happiest I've ever
been. Zozan, what are you doing now that you're off stage?
I don't recognize this language.
Don't worry about it.
It's not princess, don't worry about it. I suddenly crave some cheese, meat, and dough.
There's some falafels that are prepared on the tray.
I go there.
That's awesome.
I love this song.
I love it.
Amarisa gives a wink to you.
I finger gun to her.
What the fuck is going on anymore?
And I then start looking around if I see Bobo anywhere.
Yeah, Bobo, whoops, I don't know why, whoops, I moved to the wrong tab. Bobo is, the deviled eggs are gone, so he's kind of moved to a corner and is sitting down muttering things under his breath.
I sneak in, Bobo.
Oh, hey there, Mickey.
How you doing, bud?
Oh, I've never felt more alive.
Yeah, the song's pretty great, right?
You think this song's great? Wait till you hear my song.
Oh. Hold on, I'm just gonna go for a little moment. And I sneak off to Bayou.
Hey, Bayou?
I'm just going to assume that I've been eating again because it's a party, sort of like jiving with the music. Like, wow, I really get this song. Hello there, Veyu. Hello there, me. Hello there, Jason. How can I help you?
I might have caused a little issue.
In mid-bite, I just swallow hard. What do you mean?
On a scale of 1 to 10, it's a Bobo.
A Bobo? I hate that guy. What did you do now? What is he planning?
He wants to play music on stage.
Okay, and he's a musician. What of it?
Remember last time he played music?
Oh, right.
And I kind of promised him to be a guest on our next performance. Didn't quite think about the cricket
song. No. You can just stop right there. You didn't quite think. It's fine.
Yeah.
So
I blamed
what do we
the
do
arrow
now?
Through my stomach.
Well. Oh, right. Arrow. Can Gazumbo have side quests?
Gazumbo, yeah, alright, well, flip over to Gazumbo's perspective now. Gazumbo, what's going on with you?
Okay, Gazumbo has had eyes on that quiver all night.
Okay.
I want to steal one arrow.
Alright, what's your exact plan? If you were to describe what you plan to do, tell me what it is.
Okay, is she dancing around with them on her back?
She's not dancing. She's sitting at the bar.
I was about to say that I wanted to invite her to dance with Grayley and I.
Okay. No, yeah. So we'll say that that's already happened. And so all three of them are kind of having some girl time.
Yeah. Just some some good old girl time.
Okay.
Just girls being girls, girls being girls.
Yes,
just
I'm going to
the ladies.
Yeah, I'm going to stealthily, as a giant Goron, sneak through the crowd and just pluck one on my way out.
Just hide it up my sleeve. Just one as you pass by.
That's right.
Yeah, just one. Just one.
Okay, and she's distracted with dancing.
Yep.
So roll for me now.
Okay. Yeah. Ooh, 9.
Okay, that is literally the exact... You just hit what I had set to be the... What I needed for you to be able to steal
all
this arrow.
All of my training has led me to this moment.
So you 15 in total, which is what I thought would be reasonable for this. You managed to steal one arrow unnoticed and walk off with it.
Okay. Good. I will go hide in the shadows and wait my turn. But don't worry, I will come back.
Gazombo does not know what this thing does yet.
Does he? Gazombo heard love arrow. That's all he needs.
Oh, yeah, I'll call him love arrows.
Why?
Love in quotes.
Give Gazombo time, all will be revealed.
Okay. Oh, no, okay.
Oh, no.
The Fast Lion family.
He's got a plan.
Should we go back to us trying to find out what to do with Bobo?
Alright, yeah. So now, unless Sonora has something that she'd like to do in particular while she's dancing with these ladies.
Having scandalous. A good time. I kind of want to check in with the guys to see how they're doing, what they're up to, but I don't know.
Nah! Not a girls' night!
It is girls' night.
Wow, is it always this fun up here in Sunbury Town?
That's since I've been here. Really?
Oh, it's usually pretty boring, actually. You guys are the most exciting thing that's ever happened to me or to this town. Mostly to me. Alright, now I'll flip over to...
Ignorant! Terribly thought out!
Yeah!
Empty-headed!
What? I'm not gonna bring up the Lionel because I think we have beaten that to the ground now.
I make one mistake while you have several of your Hylian forsaken plans.
Alright, let's now compare this. My plans have just caused some public disruption.
You're going to have all of Sunbury Town buried in crickets!
Your plan, on the other hand, and I lift my shirt, did this!
Okay, I am not going to just bring up this Lionel again. You did this to me! Look at this!
It's okay. It's okay. Here's the plan.
Okay.
Let's just let the gentleman perform, and if it gets out of hand, we'll subdue him.
Subdue him? How?
I take out an arrow. Subdue
okay.
him.
I take out the shock arrow. Like, poke.
We'll just see how much subduing is necessary.
Fair enough. I just look at the chest.
I don't know why the chat loves Bobo so much. I don't know why I love him so much, because I keep writing him into the story. Bobo's not earned this praise. But speak of the devil, he kind of walks up to the conversation that Vayu and Zozan are having and says,
"So, I can see that you guys don't like dancing either."
Whoa!
Oh, and that's how you properly fletch an arrow.
Oh, thanks. I've been missing my shots lately. I need to know how to do this.
Ah, Bobo, sorry. Yes. Not much of a dancer myself. Surely all of my skill is in the wingers, as you see.
I'm saving myself for performance. Don't take it the wrong way!
Anyway, Bobo, friend, what brings you over to this conversation?
Did you just call me a friend?
I'm surprised that's the part of the conversation you're picking out, but yes.
He looks down at the drink he's having and kind of stares at his reflection and looks back up and says, when are you performing again?
Generally whenever Soother tells us to.
He walks off. He walks off, ignoring whatever you were trying to say.
Okay.
This is why I was concerned after realizing he was going to play a song.
What? I mean, it's just music.
Yeah, like your fireball music.
No, see, that's a song. This is music.
Fair
like
point.
I said, there's four of us, one of him, potentially 1,000 crickets, but we killed one large bug. I'm sure 1,000 small bugs won't be a difficult task.
I mean, the problem is the tree most likely won't kill them. It won't only cultivate them.
Look, I have no large... I have no... I'm only slightly concerned. Let's see where the night takes us. And again, if anything happens, subdue.
I just pull my arrow in the sleeve.
Okay. So you hear kind of a muttering sound coming from next to you, and over at the drinks, Soother has been getting pretty heavy into it.
Oh and no!
He's kind of, his vision's blurred. He's looking around, but he keeps glossing over at Zozan and muttering something. This is getting massive.
Is he staring at me?
I mean, probably. What does it matter to you?
You're looking at me?
I don't know, but I have a Bobo feeling about this.
Zozan.
Yeah.
Zozan, come over here.
Wish me luck.
By the grace of Hylia herself.
Thanks.
Hey,
Soother.
Zozan.
Yes.
I couldn't help but notice that you're that bastard who punched me in the eye, aren't you?
Yes.
You son of a bitch! And he does a sucker punch in your right in your Lionel injuries, actually.
Right in the Lionel wound!
I'm just gonna take away a heart for that one.
No!
Oh, that was right. I kinda deserve that too.
And the rest of you see that this has happened.
Well, since I'm probably the closest, I'm gonna swiftly stride over and, sort of step as close to between them as I can get, and
I deserve this, man. You don't.
A man of honor.
I mean, yeah. Sure. I won't deny that you do probably deserve that for something. I'm gonna look back at Soother and say, "Are we good now, friend? Have we settled our problems?"
Who the fuck you think you're talking to? Alright? the mayor of Sunbury Town.
Okay, now I want to sucker punch you again.
No, I won't. I won't. It hurts too much. But I wanna.
I won't.
But I'd like to.
Yes, yes, and we wouldn't want a smear campaign getting spread around regarding the mayor of Sunbury Town assaulting citizens, would we?
At this point, can I have Noticin come over here?
Oh, yeah, yeah, sure. Sonora, okay. get your ass over here.
Alright.
Damn.
Brother,
hey, Soother, remember, you're not mayor yet, so still... Remember, you're supposed to make you look good tonight, huh? This is your festival. Sure.
You're right. And he just kind of, he goes in for a hug kind of on Sonora, not really tall enough to get too much over her belly button.
Oh.
And just kind of slides down onto the floor, and flops down at her feet. You're right.
He just like takes a nap on the ground.
Maybe a place we can. Hide them away.
Maybe we should slide. Do the tables have like long tablecloths?
They do. In fact, I specifically wrote it that way.
I was thinking more of bed.
We
can
just...
make a makeshift bed.
No, I'm just gonna and I can like slide him the table.
All right, you kick him under the table and no. Wait. Do a stealth roll actually.
Okay.
Oh no.
It's a low check. Okay, that's good. That's perfect. You slide him in, no one notices, and the party continues as normal.
Okay, good.
Did you say anything?
I was gonna say you should put your jacket under his head for a pillow.
Ow.
No.
Why not?
Does anyone... Well,
I'm not going to let any of these clothes that we've procured get covered in anything that might come.
He has to cover it himself.
I don't believe that happened. I'm sure he would find some way to make us pay for it.
I'm sure he'll be fine.
Yeah, he's taking a nap right now. He's off in dreamland.
Guess I'm gonna go back to hiding then.
I hate when he does that. It's been a while, but I hate when they do it.
All right, well,
you never know where he will show up next time.
Whoosh.
You will hear him. You won't see him.
Gross. What are we doing now? Are we just... Are we waiting for our next set?
Looking under the table, is there going to be another table. Set?
You find a list on him with your scheduled times, and you can see that you still got, like, an hour before your next performance.
Oh, wow.
Then. Well, I've done about as much eating and socializing as I'm comfortable doing.
I kind of hurt, but...
Boo, party pooper.
Zuzin, why don't you have another drink?
I will.
Okay.
I need something
for him. I need something.
The divine voice of Hylia compels me to drink.
I need something to alleviate the pain.
Well, I had anticipated him drinking a little bit when I wrote in what happened next.
Those Zo boys, they drive me to drink.
Zo boys, it's perfect.
So Zozin, through Zoshin, through all this drinking and dancing and the flashing lights, you're beginning to feel disoriented. And it's just like you felt after the Moldorm knocked you around like a pool ball. And just like then, your double vision starts to form a singular vision of Princess Zelda in front of you.
here for you.
Hang on. Is the call cutting out, or are you not saying anything?
Yeah, no, I didn't hear, so sorry, the call cut out.
The call cut out, I'm sorry. Yeah, Princess Zelda's in front of you.
What are you doing here?
What are you doing?
Well, I'm sorry, should I leave, or
what? sorry, just hurt on the inside. And the outside, and a couple of drinks.
I
don't know if you're real.
Oh, I know. Your voice has been ringing in my ear today. You're being very much yourself.
Sorry about that.
Is this a party?
Yes, a party for the maybe upcoming late mayor.
My champion, I have a big request to ask of you. It's a bit of an imposition, but it would really make me happy.
I will listen. I haven't said no to anyone yet.
What a claim.
Liar!
He can't say no.
I want you, my champion. I want your body.
What? Yeah.
See, I know a song that can allow me to inhabit your body for a temporary amount of time. I haven't had a body in a century, and I would very much like to use yours tonight, so I can know what it's like to be alive again. Is that okay?
You know, despite the wording, I will say yes. I could take a little out-of-body experience for a while.
I just apologize for anybody that might be listening to this right now and thinking, what the fuck?
I'm gonna permit you to do it.
You hear, no instruments play, but you hear a song kind of surround you, and Zozin, it's a little blurry, exactly when the change of perception happened. But you notice that you're looking at the back of your own head.
Oh. When I said out-of-body experience, I didn't quite expect it to literally be it. Not complaining!
You're somehow floating behind yourself. And if it's Princess Zelda that's in Zozin, and you're behind her, you try to look at your current set of hands, and they're invisible even to you. You're just a wisp floating around the saloon, and you can whisper around as you please.
Well, that's oddly horrifying.
We're going to take a short commercial break at this point. So stick around.
Someone appears before you and says, I want your body. You say, yes, ma'am.
We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be back with more Scattered Heroes shortly.
All right. So
stick with us. And
we're fucking
back.
Hell!
For those who are not yet absorbed into the Challenger Approaching family, I Eat Beans is a song that hasn't been heard in a long time, but it's about our Norwegian friend Gamerstats, whose favorite food is beans.
Who may or may not eat beans.
That version hasn't been ever shown before, the version that fades into I Eat Beans from the actual song, but he was listening to it, and like, we were in the Discord call, and he says, you know, oh, never mind. For a second, I thought this would be, as the Norwegian, I have to say, I Eat Beans song. And then, as he finishes that sentence, during that sentence, it transitions over to, I Eat Beans!
I was so it was just funny to hear the whiplash of his, like,
yeah, for a second I thought this was going to be I Eat Beans.
Let's continue the story, why don't we? As you recall from before the commercial break, you have slipped Soother underneath the table. And
it's fine.
Gave him a little Soother under the table, if you know what I mean.
And unbeknownst to everyone at the party, except for
Zozan. You know what that sounds like.
Princess Zelda is currently inhabiting the body of Zozan. And to everyone else at this party, Zozan was dancing along. He froze in place for about a minute. And then he began dancing again.
I mean, that seems pretty normal for him.
That's fine.
All right, then.
Blame it on the wounds.
Blame it on the wounds. Blame it on the
wounds, baby.
How many times can we reference that song in one campaign?
Let's find out.
Zelda expected to be filled with an indescribable joy to actually be flesh and blood again for the first time in 100 years.
What she did not expect
was the alcohol in Zozan's body would transform.
Oh, Jesus Christ,
we've got to fucking be filled with an indescribable amount of booze. It's not just that he drinks a lot, it's that he can't hold it. He's very small.
He's small child.
Small man child, but.
So, Zozan heads over to the crowd who's still gathered around, kind of where they dumped Soother. And she says, "Hello, my friends!
Hi, Zozan.
Hey.
Doing okay? Having a good time?
I feel great! Why aren't you guys dancing?
Hey, have you eaten anything tonight? drinking water?
I haven't eaten anything. And she runs over to the table and starts cramming things in her mouth.
It tastes so good.
My beard.
He's acting like he's she starts pulling on the beard. Ow! Ow!
Excuse me, ladies.
Is it me, or is Zozan acting a little strange even for him?
I think maybe we should check on him.
Yeah, maybe we should, yeah, let's just get him. Let's do something with him. I just don't want him doing what he's doing right now.
And I realize, well, I'm sober now, and...
Can't Zelda see me?
No, she cannot. She can't. No one can see you.
You, not only did you give your body away, but you fucking can't even be seen by the person you gave it to.
Good job.
I should have thought these things through now that I can think about it properly.
Now that I'm sober, I can see this is terrible.
So, I want to approach Zozan and just kind of be like, hey, guy.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe we,
what's up, we Rito?
excuse me. I'm willing to overlook that transgression given your inebriation, but you're beginning to make a you-know-what out of yourself, and I believe that we should probably draw less attention to ourselves if possible.
She leans in and says, "You want to hear a secret?"
Sure. Would you mind telling me over here in the corner?
So she walks over with Veyu in the corner and says, "I'm Princess Zelda. Shh, don't tell anyone."
Oh no, you are not going to do this to me. Zozan, I've had it up to... I legitimately apologize for the Lionel thing, okay? I do. I sincerely do. But
he apologized.
This is going too far.
He apologized, and Zozan... And it wasn't actually Zozan he apologized to.
You can't walk around a city claiming to be Zelda. Not only will people think that you're insane, it's probably sacrilegious.
Okay, I see your point. I am actually Princess Zelda. So...
Okay. Also, prove it!
Also, I'm not actually telling anyone except for you, so... What's the big deal?
Okay, you know, fine.
Random unzipping sounds are bad in the stream.
You got me there, Zelda. Let's
no, no, let's no, just... no. I was just zipping up my ukulele because my cat started to play with it.
Let's just keep this between you and me. As long as you don't tell anybody else, you could be the queen of the Zora for all I care. But try to keep a low profile.
They have a queen?
Maybe.
Probably.
Maybe.
I'm just hovering around all the time, just talking to myself.
Okay. We can't hear you.
Yeah.
Zelzen says...
Zoda
says, "Okay, I will not draw any attention to myself whatsoever. I'll just, you know, be Zelzen." And
I don't like where this is going.
She walks into the woman's restroom.
Oh, my the gods.
Sonora!
what? Hey, what? What's up? Where did this
I think there's something in the restroom that requires your attention, I say, making a, like, beard motion over my chin.
What you, did somebody throw up?
Like, I think there's a, and I make, like, a dancing motion, somebody in the bathroom
I think the men's room is over there.
Zosin is in the ladies' room!
And as he says that, some people in the crowd are just like, what? Fast-footed Zosin? He said,
no, sorry, private conversation. And I, like, throw my wing over Sinner's shoulder and, like, Zosin is acting incredibly strange. I think he may have had 1 or 10 too many to drink tonight. Mm-hmm. He thinks he's Zelda, and now he's in the ladies' room.
I only drank 6.
I'm on my way. I run over to the ladies' room.
You as you walk over to it, several women are leaving it with a bit of disgust on their face. And you walk into the bathroom and hear, I'm peeing standing up! I've always wanted to try that!
Oh, God, so no. Why?
Wait, what the?
We apparently did. Is he... Where is Zosin? Like, how is he situated? Is he in a stall?
Oh, I mean, how is Zelda?
Okay. Otherwise, he's...
you're Zip, and then Zosin, quote-unquote, walks out of the stall and goes to wash her hands.
At least she has public
decency. Hey, Zosin.
It's the Gerudo.
Yes, it's me. I grab him by the ear. Do you know where you are right now?
Oh, oops. I was supposed to go in the other one, wasn't I?
Yeah. I say okay, are your hands clean?
Yeah, she holds them up to you. Yes.
Okay. I lead Zosin out of the room and back to the group.
Alright, the four of you are together again. And
as soon as Sonora brings Zosin out, I want to have been like basically conversing with, assuming Gazombo, are you with us now?
Can Gazombo say hi, Dean?
Yeah,
you don't have to hide the whole time.
I do. All part of Gazumbo plan.
Okay, Gazumbo's
okay. Well, then if Sinura approaches me with Zosin in tow, I'm gonna have like my back to them, and I'm gonna be like, now where is that Goron? His brother is causing a riots in this party.
Zosin's acting way weirder than usual. I haven't seen Gazumbo since our last set ended. What's going on here?
I don't know, but at this point, do we have any rope? Do we have rope? At this point, I'm willing to just tie them up and leave them under the table. Soothe her.
No, don't!
I don't care if they tear each other apart at this point.
Actually, Veyu, have you seen Gazombo lately?
No, I haven't seen Gazombo, which aside from the fact that it's strange I lost sight of the largest member of our party, to be completely honest, I'm going to have to tear him a new one, given that it's his brother that's going nuts here.
Are you talking about the Goron? Because he's a ninja, so it makes sense that you wouldn't be able to see him.
Oh, does it make sense that it would be hard for you to see? Thank you, Zosin.
You should now by now obviously realize he's referring to his own brother as the Goron.
So you hear something?
Nah, probably nothing.
Yeah.
You paying attention to the clock know that you've got to reform again in about 10 minutes.
And Gazombo's gone, Zosin's drunk as a piss horse, and we have to perform in 10 minutes? Sonora, this is gonna require...
What else could go wrong?
And then Bobo walks up to you and says, hey, remember, we've got our deal.
Excuse me?
And then he walks away.
What was that?
bird's head tear ducts, I'd be crying.
Okay. Are we performing? Because I happen to be a very good musician.
No, Zozen, you're not. Which is why we need you to dance. Yeah. As you always do.
Are you able to dance?
I can dance! And she starts just like bobbing her head, the most sporadic, inhuman motions you've ever seen, because this is, she's just so excited to be in a body. Woo!
Oh, I just want tonight to be over. I just hopefully the rest of the party is drunk enough now that if this last set is terrible,
they
won't
move to the room and see if everyone else is drunk.
I mean, after your last performance, everyone decided to get shit-faced tonight. So,
well, worst comes to worst, they might not remember it in the morning.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. No, this just is be fine.
Let me sing. Let me try. I don't know how my voice will work through the princess.
Hey, where's Gazamo, I wonder? Well, I'm sure that if we get up on stage, he'll notice we have a set coming up and he'll join
us. Okay, so the three of you get up on stage. Gazamo, are you going to join them? Nope. Okay, Gazamo stays hidden. And you, the clock runs out.
What?
Even I started looking out for Gizamo now. Where is he?
Alright, well,
started?
Yeah, getting back up on stage. I
prepare my instrument, hoping that nothing goes wrong or unexpectedly, Ryu.
Okay, yeah, go ahead and do that and roll for me. Suddenly! No, go ahead.
16.
16, alright, that's over 20, good.
What's with all these high rolls?
That's a 12.
We're not
okay.
That.
For a 16 total.
Alright, Vayu's, I mean, it's for as much stress as he's got going on in his head right now, it's miraculous that he's able to play so beautifully anyway. Always a crowd pleaser.
He's using it.
A real pro. And Senora then is, I mean, she's the showstopper she's always been. And then
looking at, Zozen and trying to keep my eyes on him to make sure he doesn't just fall off the stage, I managed to, like, mutter out, anyway, this is Wonderwall.
Oh man, I wish I'd pre-downloaded that one from the Zelda soundtrack.
Who has to roll for Zozen's dancing?
Yeah, well, actually, let me roll.
Also, I was trying to hint towards Bobo showing up to you earlier, Ryo.
Oh, I know. I caught it. It's just not happening yet.
Okay.
Okay.
Because there's something else I wanted to happen first.
Oh God.
So, Sonora, while you're playing, and I'm not cheating. I did just roll for this and passed it. Zozen swipes the panpipe from out of your hands.
Yes!
What?
And then... Now let me roll again.
Let the record show that Senora is livid.
Nat 20 I just got on this next one.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
With already the ridiculous... Okay, so... to everyone's perception, Zozen starts playing the panpipes. And... as he does, things in the room start to float. The tables are lifting up, and no people are floating, but objects are floating. So actually, Soother's unconscious body is poking out as the table lifts up from over him. The ice sculpture has been lifting up in the air. Everyone's drinks, the drinks have come right up out of the glasses. There's some sort of magical spell being performed by Zozen tonight.
And all the roads we have to walk are wide. What the?
This is unprecedented.
I told you guys I was good at this. And she keeps playing as as things start, she's actually juggling some things up in the air with her levitation song.
And all the
should
lights.
Should we stop this or just let it ride out?
Yes, they're blinding. I'm gonna keep playing.
Okay.
Are we?
And then she returns. Since you got a nat 20 on this one, there's no difficulty in this. You just managed to put everything right back the way it should be. And as she does, the crowd thinks this is the most buckwild performance they've ever been to. They love it. They clap. They cheer. They cry. People are going to be hearing about this in the next continent over. The best concert ever performed.
Well, that was a thing.
That was
a where are you?
And after that, after you've finished up on the Wonder Wall, that is when Bobo crawls up onto the stage.
Oh no.
You're gonna be the one who saves me. Oh. Hello there, friend.
Hi, Bobo.
And he faces the audience and says, "Attention, Sunbury Town. The town that's scorned me and shamed me and treated me like dirt. I have a lot of feelings about you tonight. And whether you like it or not.
Suddenly you have an arrow in your sleeve!
I'm gonna let those feelings erupt through music. So listen up, because this is a very personal song to me. The lyrics? Well, let's just say a little birdie told me. But I've put a little Bobo twist on it. And the emotions are all mine. This song is titled, Love is Waiting at the Windowsill. Parentheses, I'm Mr. Love.
Bayou, looking on somewhat aghast, just kind of mutters out,
I don't think that one's by Oasis.
In the north they have a saying, when a man gets his sixth ab, it's time for the hunt to begin. Like a wolf stalks his prey, like the cricket stalks the moon, love watches from the window of your inn. And it's time to let Mr. Love in. I'm Mr. Love, I'm Mr. Love at your windowsill. And I missed your love, I missed your love, and the way it kills my guts. And my deep and beating red-blooded heart falls on my blistering sword. I'm a slave to my feelings, I can't hold it anymore. All this raw power I have stored. So I'm letting the love come out. So let Mr. Love come in! And then he pulls down on a rope from the ceiling. As he breaks into a squeaky flute solo. And
can I have my pipes back?
Yeah, you rip them out of Zelda's hands. approximately 200 crickets rain from the ceiling as a hatch opens. And they fall onto people's heads, they land in the food, and in the punch, and they scurry off wildly in every direction. And people are screaming as they run into the building, and in the chaos, a man drops a cigar and accidentally lights a table on fire.
I cast Daruk's Protection on Grayley.
Okay. What do you roll?
16.
Okay. So that's... I've got this pre-cast.
I knew the crickets weren't here.
I mean, obviously she's like the target, right?
I mean, maybe. Well, the crickets are just going everywhere. It's not like they landed on someone.
Then I'm Don Gustavo.
But due to your Daruk's Protection...
I'm most scared for her, we'll say that.
Due to your Daruk's Protection, none of them come close... No crickets come close to landing on her. They just kind of bounce off. And now that you're looking at Grayley in particular, she is frozen in her steps. She is just staring at the stage, her jaw hanging wide open and her eyebrows raised.
You said something was on.
Oh, we're having audio issues.
Sure.
We're having audio issues. Yeah. Sorry, everyone.
On fire.
We're fine now. We just heard that Grayley staring at the stage with her mouth wide open.
Yep, that's the last thing we left off. Let's take it from there. Grayley, mouth open.
Oh, okay. No. Protection, so it's not full of cricket.
Oh, yeah. Is it the table that... under?
Oh, boy. Oh, these audio issues. I'm sorry, everyone. What was the question again?
I asked if the table that was on fire is the one that Soother is under.
Well, no, but it's spreading.
Okay.
I know you want the lady, but...
Does Kotaki's lullaby... put freeze?
I have to assume that the question you just asked is, does Kotaki's lullaby put out the fire? Was that the question? Oh man, I had such a fun show planned for you guys.
Yes, that was the question.
Oh wait, hang on. Jesus Christ! Highly restart the. Let's meet up in the backup channel that I have built.
Because it's just Rio, it sounds like. Hello?
Hi.
Does this work?
Hello?
Hi. Okay, Jay.
Hello?
All right, everyone's
what
in.
What is this? All right,
here we go. Now that we're in a different server, it seems everything's working fine.
Uh-oh. Looks like we're going DM-less.
Oh, they can't hear me. I can hear them.
Well,
what an embarrassment.
Can they hear us?
Yes, they can.
What a weird experience.
Yeah.
Yeah. They heard everything you said. But we're in a different new call now. There should be no more.
Yeah, it works now.
Oh, nope. Still having problems.
How are we doing?
Okay. Shit. All right. So there's a fire. There's Grayley and Drew's protection. What are you doing exactly?
Huh?
What?
It was going so well!
Sorry, buddy!
We heard that!
The table is on fire. There are crickets everywhere. Yeah, Grayley is in a bubble. What's going on? What are you doing?
Is old bike can put out fires, or...
And then, Ryu looks at the camera, the office style, and says, only when we're trying to do the show does this happen.
Somebody in your house trying to download something, maybe?
I don't know what the deal is. It's probably the billion tabs that I have to run the show. Your ice spell.
Yes.
Your ice spell
about that.
Will freeze the table if you cast it high enough.
If it will put out the fire though.
Your fire spell will not. It would only add to the fire. Your ice spell.
No, I'm asking if would it put out the fire or would it be ice and fire at the same time?
It would put out the fire if you get high enough.
All right. Here we go. Bum, 10.
Okay. I already calculated it. You're good. This fire goes out, and the table
awesome.
The table is frozen. The adjacent table is burnt, but the fire is gone. Bobo remains on stage, jamming out with his music.
Self in game.
Yeah.
All right. Is it Amarisa?
Yes.
Is that her name?
Yep, that's it. I tried answering character. Yes.
Good. It means girl.
God damn it.
Oh,
what?
Ryu will be here eventually.
Yeah, I'm sure he will be.
It's... we can hear...
Is Steam open?
It's always... No.
Is it Windows Update? It's on that...
Maybe I should just close the Team Viewer and you guys don't get to see what happens anymore.
To me...
Oh. I think it has me...
That CPU...
That's gotta be it.
Java's looking pretty... What?
I just killed the team viewer, though.
But
no!
Oh, yeah. Well, that seemed to fix it.
Yeah, let's go for 5 minutes without the team viewer and see if that makes the problem go away.
Okay.
It probably will.
I guess we don't need it right now.
Not at the moment.
We're not in combat. Well, we're kind of in combat.
Emotional combat.
We may or may not be in combat right now. Anyway, is... what the Rito girl, is her name Amarisa?
That is correct.
Okay, where is she? Is she just covering crickets?
She didn't run away. She's got her bow up, and she's kind of prepared for what's happening.
Okay, so...
for the guy.
She can probably take care of herself. Alright. So, guys, what's our priority here? Take care of clearing out these crickets?
I mean, I'm not going to fire arrows at a bunch of crickets. I mean, we could just escort everybody out of the building.
You have a oh, yeah, people.
Yeah, okay.
So, can we just be like, all right, everybody, come now, follow us, just a typical emergency cricket, nothing to be worried about.
Sure, Veyu can take the liberty of leading people out of the building.
Follow me, don't worry, they're just party crickets, they didn't realize they weren't invited, come on now, it's a simple mistake, we've all crashed a party accidentally, right?
Yeah.
The person who is not exiting, well, Amarix is remaining, because she wants to be in on the action in case something happens, but Grayley just remains frozen in place, staring up at the stage, and Bobo remains on stage, tooting his horn.
When? I don't know where this is going. Gizambo!
Waiting.
I almost want to roll a perception just to find out where he is and not tell anyone.
You cannot perceive hard enough to find Gazembo.
So, Gazembo, get down here right now and help.
Waiting.
He's useless.
Sadly waiting.
We need people out of the building. I don't know what you guys are doing.
We need to do something about Bobo. Zozan, you want to help?
Ryu?
Oh, right, I'm Zozan now. I kind of forgot about that one. I'll help. What should I do?
Well, we could try to stop Bobo. His song is controlling the crickets.
Okay, then... I will control the crickets. Hand me your panpipes.
Wait, what? No, that's crazy.
Although,
you did just make a bunch of things. You know what? Fine. Here, take it.
Okay. Now to contest Zelda's role against...
I don't know where you learned this, play this thing.
Bobo wins. Bobo wins.
No, Bobo does not win. Bobo didn't stand a fucking chance.
I've been drinking the wrong stuff.
The crickets, which were wildly and chaotically running around before, all freeze and then turn towards Bobo. And then they start marching at him, and actually they swarm him, and he drowns into the crickets.
Zozan, what did you do?
You told me to control the crickets.
You said you wanted to control the crickets. I just told you to stop him.
Right. No, that's right. You're right. And she releases the crickets, and Bobo is exhausted, panting on the floor, just lying on the stage, as the crickets then retreat off the stage.
All right, I think he stopped. I'm gonna go over to Grayley and check on her.
Grayley, frozen, staring at the stage.
Hey, Grayley, can you hear me? Can you see me? Come on, come talk to me.
Senora.
Yeah, it's me. It's Senora.
Yes, Gazambo. Yes, Gazambo.
Yes, Gazambo.
Is Daruk's protection still up?
Yes, it is.
On her, yes.
Yes, it is.
Gazambo, wait.
You would know.
Gazambo, wait. Okay.
Gazambo, wait.
She says, I had no idea that Bobo, the stable boy, had so much raw passion in his heart. This chaos. This is art. And she collapses to her knees.
Hey, Bobo. Come over here. I think you two have a lot to talk about.
Wait, Senora, and Grayley pulls you aside. But Bobo, he's a man. And just like you told me, all men are idiots. I wrote it down on a spare tissue. I told myself I was just done with men forever. And I wish there was some way you could like both women and men, but...
If only there was some way.
Don't count that out. I didn't.
What do you... You mean... Whoa. Like, you can just do that?
Like, wait, you mean that's not illegal?
You just have to be true to yourself.
Oh man, now I wish I had True to Myself downloaded for my Zelda music.
True to yourself.
And,
just be true to your heart.
Sorry. Bobo has made it over, and Grayley turns to him and places her hands on his arm and says, Bobo, why did you never tell me that you had all these feelings? I never thought you'd understand. And it wasn't until, you know, a man named Michael taught me that you can express yourself through music. Your music's beautiful, Bobo. And,
Wait, hang on.
Yeah?
Have we... Michael? Have we met...
Bobo's better with names.
Oh, okay.
The two hold each other in a tight embrace, and they start swaying together.
So I'm gonna walk back in at this point, having, like, cleared everybody out, sort of trying to step over the last remaining crickets that are in the building, and I'm gonna, like, be dusting my wings together, going, well, that takes care of everybody else. How did... Oh.
Bad timing, bro.
It's a happy ending for everyone! And Zozan plays the panpipes, and the crickets then pick up the record and put it back on the ground. And it starts playing a nice slow dance.
Oh no, we can't hear the slow dance.
Oh, you can't hear it in this call?
No, shoot.
You need voice meter.
That's disappointing. Well, actually, we can actually probably head back over to the other call at this point.
Okay. Well, do we still need Team Viewer?
Yeah, I'll hook you up. Let's just all head back to the main channel.
All right.
Okay.
All right.
We back.
That was a lot of dings. Ryu, mute and unmute.
Be back.
There we go.
Grayley and Bobo dance together to the music that they hear, and the crickets form several rings around them and hop in synchronized circles, alternating directions by row. There's a thought that's prevalent in our media that two people can complete each other, and I don't know about that. I certainly wouldn't apply that to Grayley and Bobo, as one wouldn't say that a house fire completes a trash can fire. Independently, they're both just fires, but together they do make quite a flame, and in a way that is beautiful.
At this point, Gazembo's gonna walk up. Well,
really sad.
Yeah, guess I will be eating this after all.
Gazembo, where have you been?
Well, you see, Gazembo was waiting for her to look at Bobo. You see, I heard it was a love arrow, and I was going to stab Grayley with it when she looked at Bobo. Then you put Drew's pretension up around Grayley, so Gazembo had to wait. But it worked out anyway!
And Amarisa hears this and walks over and says, Is that one of my arrows? Gazembo, those are filled with a deadly toxin.
What? What, you called them love arrows?
This could have been lethal to her. Give that back.
Here. Sorry. Here. Oh, I didn't poke my finger on it. Oh. I thought the solution was, you know, poke with love happened, and then we fix everything.
I think the important thing here is that we've all learned a lesson.
Bobo's learned that his emotions can be channeled for good. Grayley's learned that you can like both boys and girls. Kazamba's learned that love can sometimes also mean deadly neurotoxin.
I did it! No!
What is love but a deadly neurotoxin? Don't hurt me.
And Zelda, of course, learned nothing, and she just runs over and drops kicks the ice sculpture and knocks it over.
What? And she...
All right, let's get this party started.
And she just tears off screaming, drop kicks, and the screen freezes. Don't you forget about
it. Gazembo
will go pick up Soother, though.
I'm so tempted to call a stream here, but I mean, we could do more show if we wanted. I don't know.
Yeah, the night is young.
Do you think, between my players, do you think we should keep going, or do you think we should just end the story here?
I think we can keep going a little bit.
I don't mind either way. I think that was a really great, like, ending of an episode, but if you wanted to do something for, like, the next half hour, I guess, I mean, I'm not opposed to it.
I'm gonna keep going and maybe wrap up what's happening here with Zelda.
Okay.
Okay.
Just give me 2 seconds.
Oh, no. Bye. Yes?
There we go. I just heard some noise, so I just tried to fix something.
Ah.
God damn it. I wonder why.
Would have killed somebody. Oh boy.
But yeah, I'm back.
Hang on, let me get on some good music here. Oh, what the hell?
Uh-oh. I don't. What?
Good hell, bad hell.
I hear bubbling.
I don't recognize it from.
God damn it. Are the mobs gonna dance?
And as the music kicks back up from the slow dance, Zelda at least is dancing with Popo and Grayley in the middle of the room.
Just like circling them.
Oh, is it so, guys? Ever had one of those feelings where you feel like your life just wasn't under your own control anymore? Like, things just went spinning so far off the rails that you're not even near the train anymore.
All the time.
I don't
Honestly,
know what
this feels
you
like
mean.
A normal day.
We're never in the driver's seat of life, Bayou. You can only pick the stage. Wait, that metaphor doesn't work here. Never mind, I take that back.
Anyway, Gazombo's here now. Gazombo!
Yes?
Fix your brother!
What's wrong with him?
Everything!
I mean, he drank and drop-kicked an ice statue. This seems pretty standard for those in. I'm going to pick him up.
He's good at music.
Yeah, that's a little surprising, but I guess he got the feet in his head now. That's great.
I hate you.
Just slap him!
Do you...
Just go... Go get him, please.
Oh, okay.
Oh, Goron! Are you here to dance with me?
What did you call Gozembo? Here, I'll show you the one person dance. I'm like scooping him up in my arms. Rock of Isos, and what are you doing? Let's go back over here.
Oh,
I got him.
Hey, you. Oh no, wait. Actually, never mind. She does not know your name, Rito.
How does she not know our name?
Because you, it's never Alcohol. Come up. It has not come up.
Oh, I thought she would have.
I could have swore she referred to us by name before, but
no, I think she
check the
I
tape.
I believe she made it just by race.
I would assume she would have known it before she called us, but whatever, it's fine.
Look, you've been acting very strange, even for a drunken you, Zozin.
Can I tell them our secret?
I look to Sonura and I look to Gazombo. He's been blathering on all evening about how he thinks he's Zelda.
What?
I'm,
is this true?
I'm not. I just not. I don't think I am Zelda. I'm Princess Zelda.
Oh.
Zosin.
Can you prove it?
Okay. Sonura, give me your fan pipes.
No. That won't be
necessary. We're two for two already.
Look, you know, it does sort of make sense that having some sort of abstract, extra-dimensional, spiritual power would have given him the ability to play your panpipes well.
Does it, Bayou? Does it make sense?
It makes more sense than him getting drunk and being able to do it.
He does got it, me there.
Does it make sense?
Look, you don't get to play that card. But okay, humor me here. Mm-hmm. Let us assume that this is Zelda.
Yeah.
Then where is Zozin?
I'm here.
I
where
don't know.
Where is Zozin?
He's somewhere in the realm of dreams. Probably taking a little nap.
Well, okay, Zelda. Would it be possible for you to relinquish that body back to its owner? We sort of need our assistance of our friends here.
Do we, Veyu? Do we?
Look, I like a good running gag as much as the next guy.
While Rude, Nora. I'm gonna go and see Hoth now and see what was behind those other doors.
Alright, Zozin leaves then and starts traveling in his wisp form to out of the town. Meanwhile, Zelda says, I think it's probably for the best if you just keep me around, like, always. Like, the Sheikah, he's cool, but I know more, and I have more musical talent, so I think I should just always, be him, you know?
Hang on, Zelda. Mm-hmm. You called Zozin to be your champion for a reason, didn't you?
Hylia did that. I didn't know him before. She chose him for me, and I don't know why. I assume he can do some cool stuff. Haven't seen it yet.
Fucking vicious.
Wait. Is this not Zozin?
Okay. We've been working under the assumption by this point that Zozin has somehow been graced by the power of Our Lady Zelda. It would explain some of the stranger things that have been happening this evening, but that does raise the question, if it is true, what happened to Zozin? And Zelda appears not to want to relinquish Zozin's body back to him.
If we're being logical, doesn't it make sense that you should have the more experienced member on your team? Which is me, Zelda.
Zelda. Which is me, Zeldor.
Hello, well, it is me, Zelda, from The Legend of Zelda.
Well, Zozin, I prefer Zozin to Zozin.
Please, we're worried about our friend. Sure, he may not be perfect, but he's part of our team.
Also, if our goal is to resurrect Link, what is he gonna think when he sees you, this?
She gets kind of a disgusted frown on his face.
Looks like Zozin to me!
She says, you guys are really harshing the mellow. If you don't want to party with me, that's fine. I'll party by myself. And then she just picks up the punch bowl and starts chugging it.
No! Gazembo, grab! Grab bowl, no!
She hobbles off to the best of her ability out of the bar.
Okay, maybe somebody helps. Oh, Jesus, this is not how I was planning to
go. Unleashed.
What's behind door number one?
Oh my god.
Wait, what doors?
He went to Dante's
platform. Zozin's going to Dante's platform. You're not there yet, though, Zozin.
Oh.
What? Would I be strong enough to pick up, Zelden?
Yeah, the problem is, you have to catch him.
Yes, I was waiting for this.
Can we just shoot out his legs?
It's time for you to put your talents to work.
If you want to try to catch him, that'll be a roll of speed against his roll.
Okay, sure.
Gazembo, try! I've tried it once before.
Even
17?
I rolled a 16. Sure, tell me if my 18 beats his whatever.
You tied, actually. He got an 18.
Can I fucking just jump him? Can I just, like, tackle him to the ground?
You take flight over and kind of plant him into the ground.
Train one and train two leave the station at the same time, going same speed. They would never catch each other. They just keep going at the same rate. This is never closing between them. Josembo, no get it.
If you got if you got the same number, I'll let Veyu catch her.
Yeah, so, my cat stole my die.
So Veyu, you managed to tackle him into the ground, her into the ground.
Yeah, so I'm just going to tackle her into the ground. Can I take out my Obi and tie his feet together? Her feet together?
Yes, if you tell me what an Obi is.
It's the belt on a kimono.
Okay. you know, just because I drew it and I don't want to waste
Weeb.
It, I'll go ahead and switch out the Zozan sprite for the alternate version that I made.
Oh, there we go, yeah.
So actually,
I tried to do it with the pillow thing, but no.
No, I saw that and I didn't want to force it. So you wrap her up. Let me go.
No, little Zelzo.
Okay. Is there any source of water nearby?
Okay, well, there's a well in town, we'll say, because there's no body of water.
Forget about it. Forget about it. Never mind. I decided it was a bad idea.
Okay.
Maybe we should just take her back to the inn and let her get some sleep. Thanks for a minute. Does she sleep?
Well, we're about to find out.
It's a physical body. If it's affected by alcohol, I guess it's also affected by sleepiness.
You want your friend back?
Yes. That is kind of what's causing this entire issue.
If you don't let me go, then I'll... She moved her thumb and digs it into his Lionel wounds. I'll hurt him!
Oh, God.
Whoa!
Okay,
what
let's
is
all
with
calm
this
down,
chick?
Calm. We're very calm.
Alcohol is
a terrible thing.
It's a hell of a drug. All right, you know what? Here. I think she needs to sleep this off.
Yeah, if she doesn't rip open his body.
Into a nice warm bed. How's that sound, huh?
I don't want to go to bed. I want to party. Kiss me! I want to live!
Whoa, hey,
is Gazembo nearby? Have I made it here yet?
Yeah, you're here.
Gazembo jump.
Okay, roll. All
right. Oh my god.
Oh god.
11.
Out cold.
On my 13.
Out cold.
Huh. Well,
I worry about
she wanted to kiss
him. Percussive maintenance here.
How? Right in the kisser.
I think we're gonna need a place for them.
Okay, Zozan, real Zozan, you go to Hante's platform and look. When you look inside, the platform is not ready to be viewed exactly, and you don't see Madame Hante anywhere. You just see her diamond studded cane in the middle of the room, and then there are cages all around her, and you can see that there, you can follow them in order going up the chain of which star difficulty they belong to, and they go Moblin.
Let's see how badly screwed I could be.
Moblin in number one, it says Lizalfos in number two, in number three, a Moblin and two Bokoblins, in number four. A Lizalfos and a Boblin. In number five, three Lizalfos. In number six, a Lionel. In number seven, a Dinalfos and two Moblins. And number eight,
what's a Dinalfos?
Three Lionels.
Oh my god!
That is quickly.
But as soon as you catch all that, suddenly your body is, or your wisp form is sucked back into your body miles away, and you're, you go unconscious.
Oh, I was about to figure
out. Big scary kitty person.
So, wait. Are we all just kind of standing here with an unconscious Zelzombo?
I'm going to stay in the room for the night.
Yeah, let's just... Let's get somewhere that involves a bed and him and being in it, and we'll figure this out tomorrow.
It's been a day.
Take him to the inn.
Do you think they'll let us in?
You arrive at the inn.
I mean, we didn't do anything wrong, right?
You arrive at the inn just in time to see Bobo getting thrown out on his ass. Now you stay away from my daughter now! I told you once and I told you again, you're not allowed to step anywhere near this inn! And you can see Grayly with her head pressed up against the upstairs window. Puppy dog eyes. And Bobo walks off.
Well, that seems to be business as usual.
Status quo achieved.
I think the important thing here is that she recognizes that Bobo has a thing for her, and the two of them are into each other now, so as far as I'm concerned, that relationship problem's been solved.
I hope those two crazy kids will find a way to make it work out.
I do not know how we got here.
Sorry you had to see that, everybody. Are you here to rent a room, or...?
So we're all, like, exhausted and dirty and sweaty and carrying a, like, bundled and knocked out Zosin.
And a little bit bloody due to the wounds.
Does he have a head wound?
You did leave Soother. Soother's under the table.
Oh! Gozen will go back for Soother!
I think he's fine.
Yes, can we please have an in room, please? Please.
But what about smoke inhalation?
The place isn't on fire anymore.
Yeah, I put out the fire.
Ordinarily, I'd have to charge you, but for the scattered heroes, after that concert you put on tonight, you guys can sleep the night for free.
Oh, wonderful. At least finally something's coming with the celebrity status.
That is so kind, thank you.
How many rooms?
Well, there are four of us. Does that mean four rooms?
I will sleep with Gozembo. I mean, wait. Gozembo will sleep with I.
Gozembo will try to sleep.
So many things wrong with that sentence.
Innuendo Valentine's Day!
If I remember right, they have like a one-person-per-room policy. Is that right?
There's one bed per room, but that doesn't necessarily mean one person.
Gozembo will sleep on the floor. It's fine.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I mean, it's a free room. It's a free room.
If
you don't have to.
On the house, then I'm gonna take my own room. You guys figure out what you're doing.
All right.
So that's one room per person, then I assume.
Okay.
Yeah. And Gozembo still go back for Soother.
Okay. Gozembo goes back for Soother. Who's tucking Zosin in?
Yeah. So. The plan is to put Soother in one room, Zosin in another one, and then I'll sleep on the floor with Zosin. That way, room is still secure.
Doesn't Soother have his own room here?
Does he?
Yeah, he does.
He's a regular. Yeah.
Never mind!
still put him in the usual spot.
Gozembo comes carrying Soother over his shoulder, and Grayly's mom goes, "Oh, there he is. I was getting worried." And that night, Veyu, in your dream, every night in your dream, you see her. It's Zelda.
Does she have a lump on her head?
No, she does not, because that's not how souls work.
Yes. It's all about perspective.
No.
Is that your... The cat agrees with me!
It's not an attack, ladies and gentlemen. That's an actual cat.
No. Down.
No!
Bad cat.
Yeah.
Anyway,
She is continue. Not... She's Zelda has appeared before Vayu, and she's not, looking... She's not, like, avoiding him or anything, but she is... she's presenting herself in front of him, and she's looking down at the ground shamefully.
Hello?
I don't think it's possible for me to apologize for my behavior this last night.
Well, I mean, it was somewhat unbelievable that such a thing had actually, truly, genuinely happened, and it wasn't the drunken fancies of our party member, but... I will accept an apology, given that you ensure something like this doesn't happen again.
Yes, I will never try to inhabit a body that isn't my own again. I couldn't handle it, especially with all the alcohol, of course. I hope you know I wouldn't act like that normally, but, you know, I was drunk not only with the alcohol, but with the thrill of being alive.
Yes, emotions were running high all over that celebration. I can only blame you for a small degree.
Your name's Vayu, right?
Yes, sounds a lot better to me than being called the Rito, so...
I feel a disconnect from... the party, and I would it be too much to ask you to meditate every morning just to debrief with me?
I suppose I could. Are you asking me specifically, or the group as a whole?
It'd be nice to speak to the whole group and really connect with my champions like I did back before, and hopefully one day, when we get my body back, I can join you for real. But until then, it's better than nothing, right?
Absolutely. That is what would work best for you. I mean, we are sort of here for your sake. So if it's a briefing that you want in the morning, I'll be sure to alert my compatriots.
And then she fades away in that old Zelda fashion.
Oh, the way she do.
That old Zelda fadeaway.
Oh, Zelda.
Love watching her go.
She, like, when she fades out of existence.
Yeah, it's cool. Lots of magic. Like, ooh.
I hate to see her leave, but I love to watch her go. Kazama, do you even know what that means?
I mean, it's cool, right?
So I just imagine
like, her there she go, off,
like the way yogurt did at the end of Spaceballs.
All right. Zozen, you do not get an appearance of Zelda, but you do find a letter in your dream, and the letter it goes on for about 10 pages, but the gist of it is that Zelda's very sorry.
Yeah.
It's a breakup letter. I'm sorry, we can't keep seeing each other like this.
What? Did something else happen while I went to haunt this platform?
One of the things that she specified in the letter, catching you up on the situation, is that you will feel many injuries the next morning that you weren't necessarily aware of before, including a freshly opened puncture wound and a Gizamo chop to the head.
Why did I get shot again?
No, she had, like, opened the... Oh, man, yeah. Why me? What did I deserve? Well, a lot of things, but... Why?
What was the primary thing I did to deserve this?
Which specifically... Okay, that's all I wanted to have written for this episode. So, to all be right. continued right here.
No.
Wait!
Yeah.
Gazumbo get dream rocks!
Gazumbo, in your dream, it's just an ocean of rocks. It's a special present, a reward for wrong. Oh, speaking of rewards, let's see if anyone... okay, so...
For the three performances that you did, Veyu, you did phenomenal on two of them, so there's two extra Hylia points. Sonora, you did phenomenal on all three of them. So there's
nice.
Zosin, you did phenomenally. Oh man, that Zosin alcohol. One of them, there, I'll give you one. And Gazumbo, for being the drummer.
I stole an arrow of death.
Sonora is leveling up, bitches.
You did steal an arrow. I don't want to reward you another one because Gazumbo, you get enough Hylia points as it is.
Yeah, he's doing pretty well for himself, honestly.
He also disappeared for half the chapter.
I had a plan!
Zosin, I think it was clever of you.
Were you going to kill him, really?
No, I thought it was a love arrow. She called it a love arrow. No problem in love. Stabby stab.
But he almost did kill Greylake.
Zosin, I think it was really clever that you used your ghost opportunity to do some recon on Hante's platform. So, I'll highly appoint
like
that.
Like a true scout!
Okay. living up to your name.
I will say, I did protect Grayley and put out the fire.
Yeah, okay, yeah, you're the one who defused pretty much the entirety of that Boba situation.
Can I have an orb for being the super hype man at the beginning of the show?
Yeah, you know what, I like that. Here you go.
Yeah. Sure. Yeah.
And that seems like a fair distribution. I'll rewatch it again, and if you wake up tomorrow with mysterious Hylia points, it's because I thought,
mystery Hylia points.
Ooh.
What flavor will this one be?
It's all of them mixed together.
Oh, ooh.
Stay updated on www.
Frog doesn't write me. I didn't protect her from the crickets. I protected her from Gazumbo.
It's true. It wasn't useless. Go to www.zeldadnd.com to stay updated on when the next episode is going to air. And I'm also going to be uploading all of the, I'm calling them sprites, the character models, so that you can download them if you want to use them for reference or in some sort of funny meme.
Or art, whatever.
For art.
Like, yeah. Yeah, the poster that we used, the concert poster, I basically made that using the character sprites from Ryu, so you can do stuff like that.
It's also made his other self.
When's the next episode going to be, guys?
Next Monday?
Maybe I will have to let you know, because my schedule's been changing around a bit because of snow days.
Tentatively, it's next Monday. Thank you guys for being here.
Actually, I can guarantee you that it will not be next Monday.
Be next Monday. So, we'll work out a date. It'll be on ZeldaDnd.com whenever we decide on a date. Thank you for being here, and stay lovely, my Valentine.
Stay lovely!
Happy Valentine's Day!
The monster mash. It was a graveyard smash.
They did the mash.
It caught on in all.